So if you're living in 2020 and you don't have one of these things,
how are you getting through this year? I mean, seriously, like, I can understand if you have a dog, but I mean, look at this face.
This is a video from the day I first introduced my axolotls. As you can see, they immediately started doing a mating dance. Why, you may ask? Because axolotls are completely indiscriminate, they really don't care. They'll get excited over a rock, to be honest. So just so you guys know, my axolotls are gay, and they are in love.
Hello.
Now a cowboy needs a hat, and a pair of fancy boots.
Do you ever look at someone and wonder what is going on inside their head?
Seem confused that axolotls can regrow limbs. It's like a secret superpower they have that really isn't that much of a secret now that I'm saying it out loud. And pretty much any axolotl can regrow any part of their body, including parts of their brain. But how does that pertain to little Remy here, who I said has some sort of neurological issue? Well, you're in the way, Stark. You see, Remy didn't sustain loss of his brain, he sustained an injury to his brain, which just didn't heal correctly, which means he's a little lopsided. Which you can't really tell when he is sassily walking away. That's so rude, dude. That's a worm, not his tongue. It's his dinner, not part of his anatomy. But scientists are actively studying this, and I'm going to show you guys something pretty cool about how they are. Why am I waving my tongs like a wand? Scientists actually added something called a green fluorescent protein to axolotls so they could study the regrowth of their limbs and gills and all different parts of their body. And lucky for you guys, that's Remy's secret power. Isn't that cool? So yeah, Remy has kind of a superpower, but I guess they all really do. They're basically just real-life Deadpools.
Time, you know that I won't stop until I make you mine. You know that I won't stop until I make you mine. Until I make you mine. Put your hand in.
My tank looks gross, but I'm about to go ahead and rescape this entire tank, and I thought now would be a great time to explain to you guys what you need for an axolotl tank. So they're all a little bit stressed out right now because I took literally everything out of their tank. Hi, Stark, I know I'm working on it. And that's kind of why the tank looks nasty, because I've now swooshed up all the dirt and sediment that was on the bottom of the tank, and it's now just free-floating in my water. First off, the substrate I have in this tank is sand. Yes, you can have sand in your tank! Once your axolotl reaches 5 to 6 inches, sand is perfectly fine. Right, Parker? Right? I also have a filter in there, you can see that. A thermometer reading at about 60 degrees, which is alright. So let's start decorating. Axolotls like a lot of places to hide. They're a bottom-dwelling animal, so for every axolotl you have in your tank, you should have at least one space for them to hide. So I have 5 axolotls in this tank. So this big one I'm counting is 3, 4, and 5. They also don't like a lot of flow, so I like to use a plant to like kind of slow down the outflow of the filter. So this is kind of my setup for right now. I do plan on making a more in-depth video on my YouTube channel, so go subscribe. Informational feeding of the gildren. And today I kind of want to touch on some things that I've been noticing a lot here on TikTok. Mainly with misinformed owners and misinformed commenters. And yes, some of you may have heard this information already, I'm sorry. First, let's talk about housing multiple axolotls together. I get yelled at a lot in my comment section about this, and it is perfectly fine. Yes, there are some horror stories of axolotls eating their tank mates. But 99 times out of 100, this is because the owner is underfeeding the axolotls. Now let's talk about the fact that people keep commenting they're seeing them in the wild. These are a critically endangered species, guys. The ones you are seeing in lakes or creeks, including Lake Axolotl, are most likely juvenile tiger salamanders. And lastly, I want to touch on substrate again. Do not put your axolotls on rocks or stones. They are dumb. Need I remind you, this idiot right here slammed his face into the side of his tank and gave himself brain damage. Some of you guys seem confused that axolotls can regrow limbs. It's like a secret superpower they have that really isn't that much of a secret now that I'm saying it out loud. And pretty much any axolotl can regrow any part of their body, including parts of their brain. But how does that pertain to little Remy here, who I said has some sort of neurological issue? Well, you're in the way, Stark. You see, Remy didn't sustain loss of his brain, he sustained an injury to his brain, which just didn't heal correctly, which means he's a little lopsided. Which you can't really tell when he is sassily walking away. That's so rude, dude. That's a worm, not his tongue. It's his dinner, not part of his anatomy. But scientists are actively studying this, and I'm going to show you guys something pretty cool about how they are. Why am I waving my tongues like a wand? Scientists actually added something called a green fluorescent protein to axolotls so they could study the regrowth of their limbs and gills and all different parts of their body. And lucky for you guys, that's Remy's secret power. Isn't that cool? So yeah, Remy has kind of a superpower, but I guess they all really do. They're basically just real-life Deadpools.
Who's next?
Things every axolotl owner should have on hand, part one. An API master test kit to make sure that your water parameters always stay on point. A good water conditioner that does not contain aloe, I recommend Prime. And a turkey baster to spot clean poop. While Blink is still laying her eggies, let's talk a little bit about the 603 she's already laid. First, let's do a little bit of an anatomy of these eggs. So in my hand here, you can see this jelly-like substance with the little white dots in the middle. She's eating, sorry, but because she's an albino, Blink's eggs are actually white. Any non-albino axolotl, their eggs would actually be like a gray or black color. Don't ask me about that scientific fact because I don't know why. But I want to go ahead and explain the anatomy of these guys a little bit more because this is going to be super awesome for you guys to kind of watch with me over the next couple weeks as they develop. So think of these as like a chicken egg, but without the shell. So you have the jelly-like membrane that is your egg whites that is protecting the yolk, which is the white dots in the center. So since these have a clear jelly membrane, that means we're actually going to be able to watch them develop from these weird little white balls into actual little baby axolotls. And yes, that means they're going to be very, very small. Blink also actually laid three sets of twins and a set of triplets, which basically means these embryos are sharing a little sac together.
Good job, Mama. You're doing great.